Hello, good morning everybody. This is Pastor Robert of Covenant Life Church. Once again, thank you for joining me in our Sunday morning prayer. Thank you, my CLC family, for always being there every Sunday morning to stand with me in prayer. And for those of you who are not from CLC, I really do honestly appreciate your time or taking the time to join with us every Sunday morning. So we have our prayer before we start our main service. So we have this time, we start around 9:30 in the morning. So I would like to invite you, everyone, to tell your friends, okay, to join us here and to pray with us. Because the word of the Lord said that when two or three are gathered in His name, He is in our midst. I know, we are gathered online, but still, the word of the Lord stays true. We are gathered in His name. So expect, my dear brothers and sisters, that the Lord is with us today as we make our petitions known to Him. Believe with all of your heart that He is there listening to our petitions. Okay, so let us get ready and let us prepare ourselves and let's jump in the Holy Spirit and jump in the Spirit and jump in prayer and enjoy the presence of God. Okay, let us begin. Heavenly Father, we thank You so much for this another wonderful day. This is the day that You have made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Thank You that we will always experience Your goodness. We experience Your love every day. And we thank You for Your grace and we thank You for Your mercy. Thank You so much, Father God. Thank You for Your faithfulness. Thank You for Your love. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come together as a body. We come together as a people. We come together as Your children, O God. Thank You, Lord, that You are here with us, listening to our petitions as we made known to You. Thank you so much. There's nothing more we could say, but thank You, God. Honestly, from the bottom of our hearts, thank You so much. Because You're always faithful to the end. Thank You so much, Father God. Oh, we praise You. Holy Spirit, we pray in the name of Jesus, You take Your place. Take Your place in our midst. Take Your place in the midst of our prayer, God. Take Your place among us. Thank You so much, Father. Oh, thank You, Holy Spirit of God. Oh, we welcome You. We welcome You. We welcome You in our midst. Oh, we welcome You in our midst, oh God. Oh, Shandeti Nimandalashta. Oli Tineamashta Kambaramasu Kumbreme Andiashta. Ruushtam Blanderi Ishti Kimbia Mahanda. Rubro Shukumbrama Andeli Kimbrama Andeshu Kumbrama Handerasta. Oh, Shakamblahande. You are good, You are good, You are good. Oh, Shalakambla Basande. Riimbra Basukumbra Bababasukumbra Brashaka. Riim la bra babasukum brabasikim bramandirista. Riim la ma andeli bushta plan de kandalista karahande. Riim bramasukum brama andela bashta kinde aneshta. Oh, You are great, You are great, You are great, and You are good, You are good, You are good. Oh, You are good, You are good, You are good, You are good. Jesus, thank You. Thank You, thank You, thank You. Oh, shalaha kambra master. Rimlo shukumbra masa kambra mande dide yashta. Limbro sukumbra bababa sukumbra ma anderashtika. Sukumbra brahma sandegra ashta kambra mande de. He who promised is faithful. He who promised is faithful. Let us put our faith, let us put our trust in Him. Because He who promised is faithful. Life may be a journey of ups and downs. Life may be a journey that is full of challenges. But remember, He who promised is faithful. No matter how many challenges we encounter, no matter how many ups and downs we go, the Lord is faithful and He is always there for you and me. He never leaves us. He never forsakes us because He loves you and me. His love For you and me knows no bounds. It knows the boundaries. Because he loved us with everlasting love. Oh, he loves us with an everlasting love that nothing or nobody can ever separate us from the love of God. He who promised is faithful. He who promised is faithful. So hold on to the promises. Hold on to his promises. Oh, shalakam bramasan dehande, ruukubrabo shukum brama andelim bramasaka. Oh, shakam brama babasade. So, my dear brothers and sisters, stand firm. Stand firm in the faith. Let nothing move you. Oh, let nothing move you. Because he who promises faithful. Let us fulfill the call that God has for each and every one of us. Let us walk the path with faithfulness. The path that God has given you and me. Do not be moved. Oh, be steadfast. Stand firm. Let us give ourselves fully to the work of the Lord. Because we all know our work in the Lord is never in vain. It's never in vain. Because he who promised is faithful. Oh, shakam blanishta andalaka. Re'im brumosukum bramasa kam bramasande. Rebrushukum bramasande kim bramande. Oh, shalakim the brasukurama and the libro shukum bramande. Shukum the brasaka. Oh, shakam the masakim bramande day. Let us all consider that we may spur one another towards love and good deeds. Let us encourage one another. Let's encourage one another that we could show each other love, that we could share the love of Christ that he has given us, that we could share it upon others, to others, and we could share it to one another. Oh, shakalahande, rikushtukum brahmababasukum labrabashika. Let us continue to gather in prayer. Let's continue to come together. Let's continue to fellowship with the Holy Spirit together. Oh, do not forsake the fellowship. Do not forsake the fellowship. Let us encourage one another. Oh, let us encourage one another. Because when two or three that's gathered in his name, when two or three are gathered in the name of God, he is in our midst. Oh, the shakarahande. Re'im brabo shukum brabasa kam bramande. Rebro shukum brababa basaka. Oh, shalakin di biyana tash de kambramande de. Rumbro sukumbra ba as de kimbramahande. Oh, shaka. Be strong, be strong, be strong and take heart. Oh, be strong and take heart. Let all our hope be in the Lord. Let all our hope be in the Lord because he who promise is faithful. Oh, shalakande. It keeps on ringing in my spirit. He who promise is faithful. I know some of you who are in prayer right now, who's joining me right now, or who is hearing this prayer right now, know and know and know this is for you. He who promise is faithful. Do not give up. Do not stop. continue on. Be firm in your faith. Be firm in your faith. Do not give up on the fellowship. Do not give up on the fellowship of one another. Because when we have fellowship with one another, when we are gathered in the name of the Lord, He is there in our midst. We enjoy each other's company. When we come together to pray, when we come together to study His Word, the Lord is also there with you and me. Oh, I know you are hungry. I know you are thirsty for God. So let us come together. Let us come together. Let us fellowship together. Let us pray together. Let us listen to His Word together. One body, one mind, one spirit. He who promised is faithful. He is faithful, He's faithful, He's faithful. Oh, Shakim Brahanda Lashta. Rikim Brabushukum Braba Baba Sukum Brahma Ande. Riilaham Brabushukum Brahma Ande Ribama Shukum Brahma Babasande. Shukum Braba Baba Sukola Braba Baba Sike. Oh, Shaham Brabasande. Even though we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, we will fear no evil, for God is with you and me. Whenever when we go through life, its challenges, the temptations of life, the pull of this world, do not fear. Do not fear. The Lord is with you. And He who promised is faithful. The Lord is faithful. Let us put our trust in Him. Oh, let us put our faith in Him. Let us put our hope in Him. Because He is faithful, He is faithful, He is faithful, He is faithful. The Lord is faithful. Oh, Shandela Tishta Kambra. Reim Brabosho Kumbrama Andela Hastaka. Rimbrosho Kumbra Braba Basaka. Oh, your rad and your stuff, they comfort me. They're always there to protect me. You're always there to lead and guide me. You are faithful, you're faithful, you're faithful. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Holy Spirit, oh Lord, we thank you. We thank you that wherever we go, wherever we are at, you are always there with us, nurturing, leading, guiding, and most of all, strengthening us when we feel weak. You supply us with your strength. Ho sha'ala kan balabaste. Oh, shakam labrande. His power is made perfect in weakness. So when we feel like it is too much, whenever when we feel like I cannot do it anymore, whenever when we feel like I don't want to go on, let's put our trust in Him, because His power is made perfect in our weakness. When we put our trust in Him, when we put our faith in the Lord, His strength will be in each and every one of us. It will sustain us. It will carry us. It will lead us into victory. Oh, He who promised is faithful. He who promised is faithful. Oh, He who promised is faithful. His name is above every other name, and His name is Jesus. Oh, He is faithful, He is faithful, He is faithful. Oh, we thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Oh, Shamlahande Rabase. Reim Rabasukum Ramasheka Brahmande. Reim Raboshukum Brahmande Lam Rabasukum Brahmande. Sukum Rabasheki Bilabrabasuku. Reiblanda Lishtikam Brahmande Shikim Bilabrabas. We love you, Jesus. We love you, we love you, we love you. We love you, Lord. And thank you. Thank you for strengthening us. Thank you for guiding us. Thank you, Father, for always being there for us. Thank you, Holy Spirit, that you're always with us. Thank you. Oh, Shalahakande. Reimbra masukumbra madalista kam labrasa de. Reimbro sukumbra basa kandali imbro sukumbra ma ande. Oh, reimbra basukumbra mahande. Reimbra basukum lubro kundala brahmaneti kimbla mashtaka. Reimbro undolam brane shiki bra andalista kambra mandalimbraste. Shukum labras kambra mandali kimbra mandesteka. Oh, shikila handalist ambra bakandali bastiene. Rikem labrush kumbra mas kambra mandalim braboshku. Reim labrama andalim brabashu kumbra mas and dekimbra balahande. Oh, shakam labrasta. Shikim labrabasu kumbra mahande. Heavenly Father, we lift up our brothers and sisters to you, who are in need of your touch right now. God, thank you that by the stripes and by the wounds of Jesus we are healed. Lord, we take hold of the divine healing and we speak it upon everybody. Receive your healing right now in the name of Jesus. By his stripes and by his wounds, you are healed. Yes, you are healed. Receive that healing right now in the mighty name of Jesus. You are healed. Because Jesus said so. You are healed because Jesus paid for the price on the cross. That by his stripes and by his wounds, we are healed. Thank you, Father. Today we take hold of the divine healing. We claim it in the name of Jesus. I am healed. And you're healed too in the name of Jesus. Father, we also lift up our senior pastor to you. We lift up Pastor James to you. Thank you, God, for your blessing and anointing upon his life, God. Lord, we pray in the name of Jesus that you continue to anoint him. Anoint him mightily in the name of Jesus, God, that he will be able to carry everything that you have for him in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for open doors. Open doors, open doors, open doors. We pray in the name of Jesus for his life. Places, events that he doesn't even think about shall be opened upon him. We pray in the name of Jesus that he could preach you more and he could let people know who you are. Father, thank you that he will lack no good thing. Thank you that his family is blessed. They lack no good thing in the mighty name of Jesus. And Father, I lift up all of those who are praying with me right now. Thank you, God, that your blessing be upon them, that they are blessed to be a blessing. You are blessed to be a blessing in the name of Jesus. Claim it, receive it. Blessed to be a blessing, I declare upon you in the name of Jesus. You're blessed, you're blessed, you're blessed, you're blessed. You're blessed to be a blessing in Jesus' mighty name. Oh, we thank you, Father. Thank you for he who promises faithful. Thank you for your faithfulness. And thank you for your love. Thank you, Father. Thank you. In Jesus' mighty name. Everybody say amen, amen, amen. Thank you for joining me in our morning prayer. This is, once again, Pastor Robert of Covenant Life Church. Again, next Sunday at 9:30 in the morning, we always open this time. Okay, 9:30 in the morning, we always have this time for prayer. So I invite you to join me again next week. And please also invite some friends. Let us enjoy the presence of God. Let us enjoy each other's company as we pray and make our petitions known unto God. So let us do not forget, do not go away. We will soon start our praise and worship. And then let us continue to enjoy the presence of God in our praise and worship. And after that, let us also enjoy the word of the Lord that He has for us today. Once again, thank you and have a happy Sunday.
Pagi ini kami menyembah-Mu Tuhan. Pagi ini kami bersama-sama dengan para jemaat-Mu datang untuk memuliakan dan memuji nama-Mu. Kami memasuki ruang Maha Kudus-Mu Tuhan. Kami datang ke tempat tata kudus-Mu Tuhan.
Tempat tatapku. Menyembah Ku menyembahmu, good morning, everybody.
Selamat pagi semua.
You might be wondering, oh, why is this Pastor Robert?
mungkin saudara bertanya-tanya, kenapa nih Pastor Robert?
All right. Today, we will be doing
Ini kita akan memutar rekaman, tetapi saudara belum pernah melihatnya.
Alright, this is our event last Wednesday. Thanks God, it's Wednesday.
Ini adalah acara kita hari Rabu kemarin. Thanks God, today.
So we would want to share what happened and what Pastor Jane shared during time. So we will really take this time for you, give this opportunity for you and to enjoy that our senior pastor has delivered.
Jadi kita akan memberikan kesempatan bagi saudara juga untuk menikmati apa yang dibagikan Pastor James hari Rabu kemarin.
Alright, but before we do that, before we will play the video that we had last Wednesday, let us all come together first and eat a communion, the meal as a family.
Tapi sebelum kita melihat video tersebut, mari kita sebelumnya kita adakan perjamuan dulu sebagai suatu keluarga.
So I would like everybody, for those of you who are at home, to get whatever you can use for our communion. Again, it's not about the materials that we're using, but it is about what it represents that matters the most.
Jadi saudara yang ada di rumah, silakan saudara cari elemen apa yang dapat digunakan untuk perjamuan. Tidak penting apa elemen perjamuannya, tetapi yang penting adalah apa yang direpresentasikan dari perjamuan itu.
Okay, this is a meal that we can enjoy together as a family.
Ini adalah perjamuan yang dapat kita nikmati bersama sebagai satu keluarga.
And it is also a good reminder for what Jesus has done for you and me.
Ini juga adalah pengingat yang baik akan apa yang Yesus sudah lakukan bagi saudara dan saya.
That we will be reminded about his love for you and me, and we'll be reminded about his faithfulness for all of us.
Kita akan diingatkan tentang kasihnya yang besar bagi saudara dan saya, dan juga kesetiaannya bagi kita semua.
So I do believe that everybody is ready.
Saya percaya semua sudah siap.
Alright, so let us come together, let us put our hearts together, and let us enjoy this meal together.
Mari kita datang bersama, kita bersatu hati, dan mari kita nikmati perjamuan ini bersama-sama.
All right, Heavenly Father, thank you for this opportunity to come together.
Bapa, terima kasih untuk kesempatan kami dapat berkumpul bersama.
As we do this communion together.
Saat kami melakukan perjamuan bersama,
we will be reminding ourselves about your goodness and your love for us.
Kami akan mengingatkan diri kami sendiri tentang kebaikanmu dan juga tentang kasihmu bagi kami semua.
So on the night that Jesus was betrayed, he took bread.
Pada malam Yesus dikhianati, ia mengambil roti.
He blessed the bread and he broke the bread and gave it to his disciples and he said,
ia memberkati roti itu, memecah-mecahkannya, membagikan kepada para murid dan berkata,
take this all and eat from
belah dan makan.
Is my body broken up?
Ini adalah buku yang dipecahkan bagi.
No, Jesus took everything that's broken in our lives with him to the cross.
Ia, Yesus mengambil segala yang hancur di dalam hanya ke kayu salib.
That brokenness that he gives us wholeness.
Melalui kehancuran yang dideritanya, Yesus memberita keutuhan.
So whatever that is broken in our life,
apapun yang hancur di dalam hidup kita,
our bodies,
apakah mungkin tubuh kita,
our soul,
apakah mungkin jiwa kita,
and whatever it is,
apapun itu,
let us be Jesus.
Mari kita diingatkan bahwa Yesus
paid for it on the cross.
Telah menebusnya di kayu salib.
As we partake of this,
saat kita mengambil perjamuan ini,
remember that we are receiving wholeness.
Ingatlah bahwa kita menerima keutuhan.
That by his stripes and by his wounds we are healed.
Oleh bilur-bilur Yesus kita sembuh.
That through his brokenness we are made whole.
Melalui kehancurannya kita dibuat utuh.
Jesus, thank you so much.
Yesus, terima kasih banyak.
And we his wholeness.
Terima keutuhan di dalam namamu.
So let's partake of this.
Mari kita makan bersama.
When supper has ended,
setelah memakan,
he took the cup.
Ia mengambil cawan.
He blessed it and gave it to his disciples and he said,
ia memberkatinya, membagikan kepada para murid dan berkata,
take this all of you and drink from this.
Ambillah dan minumlah kamu semua.
This is my blood.
Ini adalah darahku.
The blood of the new and everlasting covenant.
Darah perjanjian baru dan kekal.
See, it is not just only new.
Bukan saja ini baru.
But it is for an everlasting covenant.
Tetapi ini juga perjanjian yang kekal.
Everlasting, that we have this for eternity.
Kekal artinya kita memilikinya selama-lamanya.
That when we receive Jesus into our hearts.
Waktu kita menerima Yesus dalam hati kita.
We are also receiving his life.
Kita juga menerima hidupnya.
And his life living in us.
Hidupnya itu hidup Yesus hidup dalam diri kita.
He will renew us, will make us a new creation.
Akan memperbaharui kita, membuat kita menjadi ciptaan yang baru.
And with that renewal,
dan dengan kita yang baru itu,
comes the adoption. We are adopted into the family of God.
Itu berarti kita diadopsi. Kita diadopsi menjadi keluarga.
Through the blood of Jesus.
Melalui darah Yesus.
You and me become sons and daughters of God.
Saudara dan saya menjadi anak-anak Tuhan.
We are partakers now of the promise.
Kita juga mendapat bagian dari janji-janjinya.
So as we partake of this cup.
Saat kita minum.
Let us be reminded.
Biarlah kita diingatkan
about Jesus giving himself for us.
Tentang Yesus yang memberikan dirinya bagi kita.
Through the blood that he has shed.
Melalui darah yang telah ia curahkan.
We are forgiven.
Kita diampuni.
We are made righteous.
Kita dibenarkan.
We are adopted.
Kita diadopsi.
We are now sons and daughters of God.
Kita sekarang adalah anak-anak Tuhan.
And therefore we are partakers of the promises that God has for his people.
Dan karena itulah kita mendapat bagian dari janji-janji Tuhan bagi umat-Nya.
And this is for an everlasting covenant with God.
Dan ini adalah perjanjian yang kekal dengan Tuhan.
Take this.
Mari kita minum.
Thank you, Jesus.
Terima kasih, Yesus.
Thank you for this opportunity that we can come together.
Terima kasih untuk kesempatan kami dapat berkumpul bersama.
And come together as a family and enjoy this meal together with you.
Kami dapat berkumpul bersama sebagai keluarga dan menikmati perjamuan bersamamu.
Thank you that your love for us is everlasting.
Terima kasih kasihmu kepada kami kekal.
And your faithfulness for us knows no boundaries.
Dan kesetiaanmu kepada kami tidak mengenal batas.
Thank you, Father, in Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Terima kasih, Bapa, dalam nama Yesus yang Maha Kuasa kami berdoa.
Amen, amen, amen.
Amin, amin.
So let us now prepare ourselves to enjoy the message that God has given to Pastor James last Wednesday.
Mari siapkan diri kita untuk menerima pesan yang Tuhan telah berikan melalui Pastor James hari Rabu kemarin.
So good reminder for us.
Itu juga sebagai pengingat yang baik bagi kita.
An encouragement for us.
Suatu dorongan bagi kita.
And to for us to remember who we are in Christ.
Dan juga sebagai pengingat siapa diri kita di dalam Kristus.
Alright, so I would not make this long. So let us enjoy the word that God has for us. Enjoy the video.
Saya tidak akan berlama-lama. Mari kita nikmati firman Tuhan. Mari nikmati bersama-sama.
Dikatakan oleh Pastor Irene.
I know that this is a week night.
Saya tahu ini adalah malam di hari biasa.
So we know that not everybody can be a part of it.
Jadi kita tahu bahwa tidak semua orang bisa bergabung.
But what we're trying to do.
Tapi apa yang kita coba lakukan?
To give as many opportunities as possible where we can come together.
Adalah memberi kesempatan sebanyak mungkin di mana kita bisa berkumpul bersama.
You know, so I know that it is not in, there is no church where everybody can attend everything.
Tidak ada gereja di mana semua orang bisa menghadiri segala acara.
So our goal is to give enough opportunity so that everybody can partake of something. That's the goal.
Jadi tujuan kita adalah menciptakan cukup banyak kesempatan sehingga setiap orang bisa ambil bagian di salah satunya.
And Pastor Robert was talking to me the other day about going back to live services and different things.
Dan Pastor Robert sudah bicara kepada saya tentang kita adakan ibadah tatap muka dan hal yang lain.
In Setiabudi.
Di Setiabudi.
I know that they're already doing regular meetings in Serpong.
Saya tahu mereka sudah lakukan pertemuan yang rutin di Serpong.
Many good things are happening.
Banyak hal baik sudah terjadi.
Make sure you stay connected, make sure you stay plugged in, make sure you stay with the flow of where God has you.
Jadi pastikanlah bahwa Anda tetap terhubung dan memastikan diri berada di tempat di mana Tuhan telah menempatkan Anda.
The world is going through a big shift right now.
Sekarang ini dunia sedang mengalami perubahan besar.
And perhaps if you are not up to date with the news around the world.
Dan kalau saja Anda tidak atau belum tahu kabar terakhir mengenai dunia ini,
you might not understand the shift and more importantly the biblical prophetic significance of the shift.
Mungkin Anda jadi belum mengerti mengenai perubahan tersebut dan arti arkitabiahnya dari perubahan tersebut.
The world is going into a lot. There are a lot of situations that the world is going into turmoil.
Ada begitu banyak situasi di mana kelihatan dunia sedang masuk dalam kekacauan.
But the word of God teaches us.
Firman Tuhan mengajar kita.
Even as the world gets darker, we, the Church of Jesus Christ, should get brighter.
Ketika dunia menjadi semakin gelap, kita gereja Yesus Kristus harus semakin terang.
There should be a brightness about us that was never before.
Harus ada terang yang terjadi pada diri kita yang belum pernah terjadi sebelumnya.
And CLC, I don't just want that for us, but our message that the church is going to get brighter must be proclaimed loudly all across Asia, all across Indonesia.
Saya tidak hanya ingin hal itu terjadi untuk kita, tapi pesan tadi mengenai bahwa gereja harus lebih bersinar, haruslah tersebar ke seluruh Indonesia, bahkan seluruh dunia.
You know, I testify to you from God's word and from my own experience and from the experience I see in other ministers.
Saya bisa bersaksi dari firman Tuhan, dari pengalaman saya sendiri, dan pengalaman dari gereja-gereja lain yang saya lihat.
There is never such a thing as a perfect time to serve God.
Tidak ada yang namanya waktu yang sempurna untuk melayani Tuhan.
CLC, did you listen to that? There is never such a thing as a perfect time to serve God.
CLC, apa Anda dengar itu? Tidak pernah ada yang namanya waktu yang sempurna untuk melayani Tuhan.
Oh, one day when all my bills are paid.
Oh, suatu hari nanti, ketika nanti semua tagihan saya sudah terbayar.
One day when the kids have graduated and gotten married and have their own house and have grandchildren.
Suatu hari nanti ketika semua anak-anak saya sudah punya rumah sendiri, sudah berkeluarga, sudah punya anak-anak dan cucu-cucu.
One day when there's no more nothing to worry about.
Suatu hari nanti ketika tidak ada lagi yang perlu dikhawatirkan.
Then I will serve God, then I will turn to God.
Maka baru saya mau melayani Tuhan, saya akan berpaling pada Tuhan.
No, listen, that day will never come. You got to learn to serve God today in the midst of all of this.
Dengar, hal itu tidak akan pernah terjadi. Anda harus belajar melayani Tuhan hari ini di tengah segala situasi Anda.
Psalm 23 tells us that he prepares a table for us in front of our enemies.
Mazmur 23 mengatakan bahwa Tuhan menyediakan meja hidangan untuk kita di hadapan lawan-lawan kita.
Even when your enemies are looking at you, God will prepare a table for you to sit and God will prepare a table for you to eat. So today Amen. Is the day to God.
Jadi bahkan waktu Anda menghadapi musuh, Tuhan sedang menyiapkan meja hidangan untuk Anda. Jadi sekaranglah saatnya.
And so we have to understand there is no perfect time, but there is a good day, which is today.
Jadi kita harus mengerti bahwa tidak ada yang namanya saat yang sempurna, tapi ada yang namanya waktu yang baik, yaitu hari ini.
This is something I've learned from scripture. This is something I've learned in my own life.
Ini sesuatu yang saya pelajari dari Alkitab dan dari pengalaman hidup saya.
If we will decide,
kalau kita mau memutuskan,
we will serve God.
Kita akan melayani Tuhan.
Nothing can stop you.
Tidak ada yang bisa menghentikan Anda.
You will decide.
Kalau Anda mau memutuskan,
I will stand on God's word.
Saya mau berdiri di atas firman Tuhan.
Nothing can stop you.
Tidak ada yang bisa menghentikan Anda.
You will decide.
Kalau Anda mau memutuskan,
I will have God's will in my life.
Saya mau mempunyai kehendak Tuhan dalam hidup saya.
Nothing can stop you.
Maka tidak ada yang bisa menghentikan Anda.
You see, that is what the devil is afraid of, you deciding.
Jadi itulah yang ditakuti oleh si iblis, bahwa Anda mengambil keputusan.
And so I found myself.
Jadi saya temukan diri saya
in this unusual situation.
Dalam sebuah situasi yang tidak biasa ini.
Where for the past few years I had so many things going around.
Di mana beberapa tahun terakhir ada begitu banyak hal yang terjadi, beberapa yang baik, beberapa yang kurang baik.
But I was also my most fruitful and productive.
Tapi saya juga berada dalam masa-masa di mana saya paling banyak berbuah dan produktif.
No, I was telling our friends in Malaysia when I did a Zoom in Malaysia the other day.
Anda tahu saya baru memberitahu rekan-rekan di Malaysia ketika saya adakan pertemuan Zoom dengan mereka.
I literally am the busiest I've ever been.
Saya sesungguhnya saat ini ada dalam masa yang paling sibuk yang pernah saya lalui.
I'm preaching 7 to 8 times a week.
Saya berkhotbah 7 sampai 8 kali dalam seminggu.
And all of my weekends are in somewhere else. You know, all my weekends are somewhere else.
Dan setiap akhir minggu saya selalu ada di tempat-tempat yang berbeda-beda.
In fact, I haven't told anyone yet. We haven't announced yet, but be praying for me.
Bahkan saya belum memberitahu siapapun, tapi berdoalah untuk saya.
In 2 days, which is Friday for me, on my Friday, which is your Saturday.
Dalam 2 hari mendatang, yaitu di tempat saya hari Jumat, di tempat Anda hari Sabtu.
I'm very happy to tell you all that I'm flying back to Jim Baker's studios. We're recording more programs for TV.
Saya dengan sangat bahagia memberitahu Anda bahwa saya akan pergi ke studio dari Jim Baker untuk merekam beberapa rekaman.
So I was surprised that they arranged for me to go back so quickly because usually they wait a long time for their people to go back, but with me they had me back in less than 2 weeks. So I'm going to do 3 programs with them when I fly up.
Saya cukup terkejut karena begitu cepat mereka dalam 2 minggu sudah mengundang saya lagi. Tapi itulah yang terjadi.
But you see, that's what life should be.
Tapi Anda lihat demikianlah hidup seharusnya.
You determined to serve God and do things God's way, God will open doors for you.
Kalau Anda mau memutuskan untuk melakukan kehendak Tuhan, Tuhan akan membukakan pintu buat Anda.
CLC, I challenge you.
CLC, saya menantang Anda.
God can be your God right where you are in the midst of your circumstances.
Tuhan bisa menjadi Tuhan Anda tepat di mana Anda berada, di tengah-tengah situasi apapun sekitar Anda.
Regardless of what is not right, God can make things right so that you can serve him and so that you can honor him and so that you can shine and be a testimony for him right where you are.
Amin. Tuhan bisa mengatur di tengah situasi Anda tepat di mana Anda berada, Anda bisa bersinar dan menjadi terang di dalam kondisi Anda sekarang.
And all the more.
Dan lebih daripada sebelumnya.
Determined to serve God.
Kita harus bertekad penuh untuk melayani Tuhan.
All the more we must be determined that God, you can stretch my time. You know, a lot of us in CSC, we believe for God to stretch and increase our money. But listen, God can also stretch your time.
Kita di CLC percaya bahwa Tuhan bisa mengembangkan keuangan kita, tapi kita juga harus percaya bahwa Tuhan bisa mengembangkan waktu kita.
You know, I know that because we believe, we always talk about how God can stretch your health and give you more health and give you more finances. But listen, God can also give you more time.
Kita selalu bicara bagaimana Tuhan bisa mengembangkan, meregangkan kesehatan Anda dan keuangan Anda, tapi Tuhan bisa melakukannya juga untuk waktu Anda.
He can cause your time to be more fruitful.
Tuhan bisa membuat waktu-waktu Anda lebih banyak berbuah.
And so I'm in this season of going to be fruitfulness. I don't want to say fruitfulness yet because I'm going to be more fruitful.
Amin. Nah, jadi saya sedang dalam masa atau waktu untuk menjadi lebih banyak lagi berbuah. Saya tidak mau bilang sekarang sudah sangat berbuah karena saya percaya akan lebih lagi banyak berbuah.
But my heart remains in Indonesia with all of you.
Tapi hati saya tetap ada di Indonesia bersama Anda semua.
And God's going to help us as we expand this. He's going to increase our time.
Dan Tuhan akan menolong kita, Tuhan akan mengembangkan waktu kita.
You know, the world, the situation that whatever situation you have is whatever situation people here have. It's all the same. Sometimes people think, oh, people in America have it better. Sometimes people think people in Singapore have it better. Sometimes people think people in Jakarta have it better. Not true. People are people everywhere they are.
Kadang orang berpikir, oh, yang ada di Amerika, orang-orang lebih baik atau di Singapura lebih baik. Tidak benar. Semua orang sama saja seperti mereka pada apa adanya.
Yesterday afternoon, I had a Zoom call.
Kemarin sore saya memiliki pertemuan Zoom
with some pastors from St. Louis.
Dengan beberapa hamba Tuhan dari St. Louis.
These are all black churches.
Mereka adalah gereja-gereja jemaat atau orang-orang kulit hitam.
And where they are, literally across the road.
Dan di mana mereka berada, di seberang jalanan.
Like, you know how Setia Budi is on one side and then across the road there are some office buildings across Setia Budi.
Anda tahu kan, seperti misalnya di gedung Setia Budi, di seberang jalan juga ada perkantoran.
Across the road from there is the gang area.
Di seberang jalan dari gereja mereka adalah area dari para geng.
You know, they call it the hood, which is the gang area. That's where the gangs are actively active.
Jadi di situ mereka sebut area itu dengan the hood, artinya di mana para geng itu sangat aktif.
And we were planning for what we can do. I'm going to do a pastors conference there in January.
Dan kami sedang merencanakan sebuah konferensi para hamba Tuhan di bulan Januari.
And when I look at how bad those, because I was just there, when I saw how bad those situations were.
Kemudian ketika saya melihat betapa buruknya situasi di sana,
my heart cried because I thought, God, how can it be that in a country that has so much money and so many good things, over on this side, look at what's happening here.
Hati saya berteriak kepada Tuhan, Tuhan, bagaimana ini bisa terjadi di negara yang sangat kaya, punya banyak uang, tapi ada hal-hal seperti ini terjadi.
You see, in every country,
Anda lihat dalam setiap negara.
Listen to this. in every country.
Anda lihat dalam setiap negara.
The devil is bad and God is good.
Iblis itu jahat dan Tuhan itu baik.
CLC, I declare to you, your father is good.
Amin. CLC, saya deklarasikan bahwa ayah Anda, bapak Anda itu baik.
And he is good to you no matter what country you live in, no matter what town, no matter what city.
Dan Tuhan tetap baik untuk Anda, tidak peduli dimanapun Anda berada, di kota apapun atau di negara manapun.
If you live in Medan, he's good to you.
Kalau Anda tinggal di Medan, Tuhan baik kepada Anda.
If you live in Serpong, he's good to you.
Amin. Kalau Anda tinggal di Serpong, Tuhan baik pada Anda.
If you live in Jakarta, he's good to you.
Kalau Anda tinggal di Jakarta, Tuhan baik kepada Anda.
The issue is not where you live. The issue is knowing that your father is good to you and your father wants to bless you. Your father wants to protect you. Your father wants to provide for you.
Amin. Masalahnya bukan di mana Anda tinggal, tapi Anda harus tahu bahwa Tuhan tetap mau memberkati Anda, melindungi Anda, dan membuat kebaikan untuk Anda.
And when we understand this,
dan ketika kita mengerti hal ini,
it frees us to live life.
Ini membebaskan kita untuk hidup merdeka.
You know, on our Bible studies, I'm so thankful we have these live Bible studies.
Saya sangat bersyukur kita memiliki penelaan Alkitab secara langsung ini.
But these are not our regular Sunday services.
Ini bukan ibadah hari Minggu kita yang biasa.
We can share a few more different things.
Kita bisa membagikan beberapa hal yang berbeda.
Because my heart still is, and I believe it's God's heart.
Dan hati saya masih tetap, dan saya percaya itu juga hati Tuhan.
That there must be more than one CLC.
Harus ada lebih daripada satu CLC saja.
I don't believe it was God's plan that there just be one CLC in Setiabudi.
Saya percaya bukanlah rencana Tuhan bahwa hanya ada satu CLC di Setiabudi saja.
God's heart is that we plant churches and make disciples.
Hati Tuhan adalah kita membangun gereja-gereja dan menciptakan murid-murid.
God's heart is that we multiply and increase so that the nation can be blessed.
Hati Tuhan adalah supaya kita berlipat ganda dan memberkati bangsa ini.
See, this is why we preach prosperity. This is why we preach that God is good, so that we can multiply and bless the nation.
Itulah sebabnya kita mengkhotbahkan tentang Tuhan itu baik, supaya kita bisa memberkati bangsa ini.
And some of you who have been in CLC longer than others.
Dan beberapa dari Anda yang sudah cukup lama berada di jemaat CLC,
it's time for you to not just listen, but it's time for you to go and do.
Bukan sekarang bukanlah saatnya lagi untuk Anda hanya mendengarkan, tapi Anda harus pergi keluar dan berbuat sesuatu.
You must always be listening, but if you only listen and you never do, then you have died. You will not grow anymore.
Anda tidak boleh hanya mendengarkan saja. Anda memang harus mendengarkan, tapi juga harus berbuat juga. Dengan demikian, itu berarti Anda bertumbuh.
I think that in church sometimes we have a lot of zombies.
Saya pikir di gereja itu seringkali ada banyak zombie.
They are dead. They just don't know they are dead.
Mereka mati, tapi mereka tidak tahu bahwa mereka mati.
No, listen. Let God bring life to you again.
Dengar, biarlah Tuhan memberi kehidupan untuk Anda lagi.
God's kingdom, to be alive means to be fruitful, to be making disciples.
Kerajaan Tuhan itu harus hidup, harus berbuah, harus menciptakan murid-murid.
We are not planning to make disciples, then we have no fruit for the Father.
Kalau kita tidak merencanakan untuk menciptakan murid-murid, maka kita tidak punya buah untuk diberikan kepada Bapa kita.
And sometimes that means that we have to be put in situations that we are not comfortable with.
Dan kadang-kadang hal itu berarti bahwa kita harus ditempatkan dalam situasi yang kurang nyaman untuk kita.
No, I let me just say this. Although I have many black friends and I have many black churches that I go to.
Jadi mari saya kasih tahu begini. Walaupun saya memiliki banyak teman-teman kulit hitam dan gereja-gereja kulit hitam yang saya layani,
being in that situation in St. Louis is unusual for me.
Berada dalam situasi seperti itu di kota St. Louis itu tidak biasa untuk saya.
Because it is so near the gang-related areas.
Karena sangat dekat sekali dengan area di mana para geng itu berada.
And to be honest, a lot of those places even white preachers don't go.
Dan sejujurnya, bahkan untuk tempat-tempat seperti itu, para hamba Tuhan kulit putih bahkan tidak mau pergi.
But if God opens an opportunity and a door.
Tapi kalau Tuhan membuka pintu dan kesempatan.
As a believer, we should step in.
Sebagai orang percaya, kita harus melangkah masuk.
Listen around you. If God opens the door for you to talk to your friends, your relatives, the people at work, as a believer, you should talk to them.
Dengar, kalau di sekitar Anda Tuhan membuka pintu di tempat kerja atau di lingkungan Anda, Anda harus berbicara kepada mereka.
Listen, CLC, everything does not need to be perfect before you serve God.
Dengar, CLC, segala sesuatu tidaklah harus menjadi sempurna dulu baru Anda melayani Tuhan.
Get rid of that old thinking, it is not true.
Singkirkanlah pemikiran yang lama itu tidak benar.
If you think like that, it's as good as saying, what if God has said, when everything is perfect, I'll send Jesus.
Kalau itu benar, maka bagaimana kalau Tuhan mengatakan, tunggu sampai segalanya sempurna, baru saya mengirim Yesus.
Then we will all still be in trouble because all of us are still not perfect.
Maka kita semua pasti ada dalam masalah karena kita semua tidak pernah sempurna.
This is my heart for us.
Inilah hati saya untuk kita.
I know it's Pastor Robert's heart. I know it's Pastor Irene's heart. I know it's many of your hearts.
Saya tahu itu juga hati dari Pastor Robert, Pastor Irene, dan hati dari banyak Anda.
But I tell you this, we have to put actions to our hearts here.
Tapi saya beritahu kalau kita harus berbuat sesuatu berdasarkan hati kita ini.
I want to challenge you with what is potentially the most important parable in the Gospels.
Saya ingin menghadirkan kepada Anda apa hal yang paling buruk yang bisa terjadi di dalam Injil.
Why do I say maybe is the most important gospel? Because Jesus said if you don't understand this parable, you won't understand the other parables.
Mengapa saya katakan ini yang paling penting? Karena Tuhan Yesus yang mengatakan kalau Anda tidak mengerti hal ini, Anda tidak bisa mengerti perumpamaan yang lain.
You have your Bible, turn with me to Mark chapter 4. If you don't, I'll read to you. Roland will read to you.
Mari kita buka sekarang Markus pasal 4. Kalau Anda tidak punya, nanti akan dibacakan.
Mark chapter 4 verse 3, Jesus teaching a parable says this.
Markus 4 ayat 3, Tuhan Yesus menyatakan sebuah perumpamaan.
Behold, a sower went out to sow.
Dengarlah, ada seorang penabur yang keluar untuk menabur.
Listen now. And as it, verse 4, and it happened as he sowed that some fell by the wayside and the birds of the air came and ate it.
Dan ayat 4 berkata, pada waktu ia menabur, sebagian benih jatuh di pinggir jalan, lalu datanglah burung dan memakannya sampai habis.
Some fell on stony ground where it did not have much earth and immediately it sprang up, but it had no depth of the earth.
Sebagian jatuh di tanah yang berbatu-batu yang tidak banyak tanahnya, lalu itu benih itu pun segera tumbuh karena tanahnya tipis.
But when the sun was up, it scorched it. This must have been like Jakarta sun, very hot. It scorched it because it had no root and it withered away.
Tapi sesudah matahari terbit, jadi ini pasti matahari di Jakarta, layulah ia dan menjadi kering karena tidak terbakar.
And verse 7, and some fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked it.
Ayat 7, sebagian lagi jatuh di tengah semak duri, lalu makin besarlah semak itu dan menghimpitnya sampai mati, sehingga ia tidak berbuah.
And it yielded no crop.
Sehingga ia tidak berbuah.
Verse 8, but other seed fell on good ground.
Ayat 8, sebagian lagi jatuh di tanah yang baik.
CLC, good ground.
CLC, tanah yang baik.
But some seed fell on good ground and yielded a crop that sprang up.
Beberapa jatuh di tanah yang baik, tumbuh dengan subur dan berbuah.
Increase and produce some 30, some 60, some 100-fold.
Hasilnya ada yang 30 kali lipat, ada yang 60 kali lipat, ada yang 100 kali lipat.
Now here you see four kinds of results.
Di sini Anda melihat 4 jenis hasil.
Now, you might say, what is the explanation for that?
Anda mungkin bertanya, apa penjelasannya?
And here is the beauty of studying your Bible.
Dan inilah indahnya dari mempelajari Alkitab Anda.
The Bible will always interpret itself. If you study big enough, it will interpret itself.
Kalau Anda cukup mempelajari Alkitab, maka Alkitab akan menjelaskan dirinya sendiri.
Jump on down to verse 13, and Jesus is now going to explain the parable he just spoke.
Mari kita loncat ke ayat 13. Tuhan Yesus akan menjelaskan perumpamaan yang baru saja beliau katakan.
Jesus said to them, "Do you not understand this parable?"
Tuhan Yesus berkata kepada mereka, "Tidakkah kamu mengerti perumpamaan ini?"
So see, we are not the only ones who didn't understand. The disciples also didn't understand the parable, right?
Jadi Anda lihat, bukan kita saja yang tidak mengerti, tapi para murid pun tidak mengerti, bukan?
And then Jesus said, "How then can you understand all the parables?"
Kemudian Tuhan Yesus bertanya, "Bagaimana kalau begitu kamu bisa memahami semua perumpamaan yang lain?"
So you see, that's why I say this is the most important parable, because Jesus said, "If you can't understand this one, you can't understand the rest."
Itu sebabnya tadi saya katakan bahwa ini perumpamaan yang paling penting, karena kalau Anda tidak bisa mengerti yang ini, Anda tidak bisa mengerti yang lain juga.
Verse 14, he's going to explain the parable now. Verse 14, the sower sows the word.
Ayat 14, sekarang Tuhan Yesus menjelaskan, penabur itu menaburkan firman. Mengapa kita datang ke gereja?
Listen, I'm thankful for CLC's worship team.
Dengar, saya bersyukur untuk tim pujian penyembahan dari CLC.
I'm thankful for CLC's nice building in Setiabudi.
Saya bersyukur untuk gedung yang indah yang ada di Setiabudi.
I'm thankful that in Serpong they also have a nice place to meet.
Amin. Saya bersyukur karena di Serpong juga ada tempat yang baik untuk kita bisa bertemu.
But listen, that's not why we come.
Tapi dengar, bukan karena itu kita datang.
The sower sows the word.
Penabur menaburkan firman.
The reason why we come is so that the word can be sown in us.
Alasan mengapa kita datang adalah supaya firman itu bisa ditaburkan pada diri kita.
This is the primary reason.
Ini adalah alasan yang utama.
The sower sows the word.
Penabur menaburkan firman.
If the word is not sown, we did not have a good meeting.
Kalau firman tidak ditabur, tidak ada gunanya kita bertemu.
And CLC, let me tell you, some of you have had a lot of seed sown into you, have had a lot of word sown into you, because you've been coming for many years and you've heard a lot of good word.
Dan jemaat CLC dengar bahwa beberapa dari Anda sudah memiliki begitu banyak taburan firman karena Anda sudah begitu lama menjadi anggota CLC.
And we can't just keep the word to ourselves anymore. We have to start giving the word, otherwise we'll be too full and explode.
Dan kita tidak boleh hanya mengumpulkan saja firman itu. Kita juga harus membagikannya. Kalau tidak, kita bisa meledak.
Listen now. The sower sows the word.
Dengarkan. Penabur menaburkan firman.
Don't be full, CLC.
Janganlah menjadi terlalu penuh, CLC.
God's priority is that the word be sown into us.
Prioritas Tuhan adalah supaya firman itu ditaburkan melalui diri kita.
He's going to talk about the first kind, verse 16. And these are the ones sown by the wayside where the word is sown.
Kita akan melihat jenis yang pertama. Ini adalah orang-orang di pinggir jalan tempat firman itu ditaburkan.
When they hear,
ketika mereka mendengar,
Satan comes immediately and takes away the word that was sown in their heart.
Segera, seketika datanglah iblis dan mengambil firman yang baru ditaburkan dalam mereka.
Now notice this. Notice that Satan comes immediately.
Perhatikan bahwa iblis datang dengan seketika, segera.
He doesn't give an opportunity of time.
Dia tidak memberikan waktu sama sekali.
But notice what he comes to steal.
Tapi perhatikan untuk apa dia datang? Apa yang ingin dia curi?
It says he comes to steal the word.
Dikatakan bahwa dia mau mencuri firman.
Now, let me put it this way.
Mari saya beritahu dengan cara begini.
When thieves come,
ketika pencuri datang,
They only steal the things that are precious.
Mereka hanya mau mencuri benda-benda yang berharga.
Thieves don't come into people's house.
Pencuri tidaklah masuk ke dalam rumah seseorang.
To steal all slippers.
Untuk mencuri sandal yang tua. Betul tidak?
Huh? Like for example, the slippers you wear at home.
Seperti contohnya, sandal yang Anda pakai di rumah.
5, 6, 7, 8 years old, the slippers.
Sudah 6, 5, 7, 8 tahun umurnya.
Please don't come to crawl into the house at night, wait until everyone is sleeping, open the windows, open the doors, come in, steal the slippers and run away.
Jadi pencuri tidaklah mengendap-endap malam hari, tunggu semua orang tidur, lalu buka jendela dan pintu, lalu mengambil sandal yang sudah tua itu.
What do they steal? They steal the important things.
Apa yang mereka mau cari? Mereka mencari hal yang penting.
Notice what the devil wants to steal.
Perhatikan apa yang iblis mau curi.
He wants to steal the word from you.
Ia ingin mencuri firman itu dari Anda.
Why? Because the devil knows that God's word in you is the most powerful thing, and if he can steal the word from out of you, then you will be defenseless against his attacks.
Mengapa? Karena dia tahu bahwa firman Tuhan dalam diri Anda akan menjadi sangat berkuasa, dan kalau firman itu dicuri, maka Anda tidak punya pertahanan apapun.
CLC, don't let the devil steal the word from you.
Amin. CLC, jangan izinkan iblis itu mencuri firman dari Anda.
Don't let offense steal the word from you.
Jangan izinkan ketersinggungan mencuri firman itu dari Anda.
Let laziness steal the word from you.
Jangan izinkan kemalasan mencuri firman itu dari Anda.
Amin. Don't let life circumstances steal the word from you.
Jangan izinkan situasi kehidupan mencuri firman itu dari Anda.
Listen, my goal with every service is to give you some good word.
Dengarkan, sasaran saya dalam setiap ibadah adalah memberikan firman yang baik kepada Anda.
From the beginning of CLC, my goal was that we must have good word every service.
Sejak awal CLC, tujuan saya adalah selalu bahwa kita harus memberikan firman yang baik dalam setiap ibadah.
My job with the help of the Holy Spirit is to deliver the word.
Tugas saya dengan pertolongan Roh Kudus adalah memberitakan firman itu.
But your job with the help of the Holy Spirit is to make sure that the devil doesn't steal the word.
Tapi tugas Anda dengan pertolongan Roh Kudus adalah memastikan supaya iblis tidak mencuri firman itu.
And you know, in the Church of Jesus Christ, we are a family.
Anda tahu bahwa dalam gereja Yesus Kristus kita adalah keluarga.
And sometimes in a family, people don't agree.
Dan kadang-kadang dalam sebuah keluarga, orang-orang tidak setuju, tidak sepaham.
But let me tell you, even when family don't agree, don't let that steal the word from you.
Tapi mari saya beritahu, walaupun dalam keluarga itu orang-orang tidak akur, tapi jangan izinkan hal itu mencuri firman itu dari Anda.
Notice it says here, when they hear, the Satan comes immediately to steal the word and take away that stone in their heart.
Perhatikan ayat ini, dikatakan bahwa iblis datang seketika, secepat mungkin dan mengambil firman itu dari diri mereka.
Verse 16. Then this is number two. This is number two. These likewise are the ones sown on stony ground.
Ayat 16 ini jenis yang kedua. Juga demikian firman itu ditabur di tanah yang berbatu-batu.
When they hear the word, immediately receive it with gladness.
Ketika mereka mendengar firman itu, mereka segera seketika menerimanya dengan senang, dengan gembira.
But they have no root in themselves.
Tapi mereka tidak punya akar. Firman itu tidak berakar.
Listen to the wording. They receive it with gladness, but they have no root.
Dengarkan perkataan ini. Mereka terima dengan senang, dengan gembira, tapi tidak punya akar.
You know, here in America,
Anda tahu di sini di Amerika,
they have a lot of soya beans.
Mereka
have a lot of soya beans.
Mereka punya banyak biji kedelai.
But you know what they don't have?
Tapi Anda tahu apa yang mereka tidak miliki?
That Asia has a lot of.
Yang dimiliki banyak di Asia.
They don't have tauge.
Mereka tidak punya toge.
You know what that is, right?
Anda tahu apa itu, bukan?
You all know what that is, right? Toge, right?
Anda,
yeah.
Anda tahu semua kan, toge?
You know a lot of Christians.
Anda tahu banyak orang Kristen.
I like toge.
Seperti toge.
You know, do you remember when you were in school?
Anda ingat waktu masih sekolah dulu?
And they let us do a little scientific experiment. We take soybeans, we put it on a cotton, we put it on a piece of cotton, we put water on it, and then in 2 days, 3 days, the tauge will grow.
Anda ingat bagaimana percobaan ilmiah dulu ketika kita di sekolah, kita ambil kapas, diberi air, kemudian kita taruh biji, dan setelah itu muncul tauge?
Masih you remember ingat? That?
Masih ingat?
And then as children, we get so excited. Wow, look, mommy, look, daddy, the tauge grew.
Dan sebagai anak-anak kita senang sekali lihat ayah ibu togenya sudah tumbuh.
But have you noticed the tauge has no roots in the soil? It's very easy to take it up.
Tapi apakah Anda perhatikan bahwa toge itu tidak punya akar yang kuat di dalam tanah, jadi mudah sekali untuk dicabut?
Many Christians are like that.
Banyak orang Kristen seperti itu.
Tauge Christians.
Orang-orang Kristen toge.
They receive the word.
Mereka terima firman.
They receive the water.
Mereka terima air.
They are very easy to pluck out.
Tapi mudah sekali untuk dicabut.
Hey, listen. It's good to eat tauge, but don't be tauge.
Memang baik untuk makan tauge, tapi jangan jadi tauge.
Huh? You must have roots to be strong.
Anda harus punya akar yang kuat.
Look at what happens here. Look at what happens here. Verse 16. These are the ones who are on stony ground who hear the word immediately receive it, but they have no root.
Ini orang yang mendengar firman dan segera menerimanya dengan gembira, tapi mereka tidak punya akar.
And so they endure only for a short time.
Sehingga mereka bertahan hanya sebentar saja.
CLC, God's heart for you is not just that you endure a short time, but that you endure with Him forever.
CLC, maksud Tuhan untuk Anda bukanlah supaya Anda hanya bertahan sebentar, tapi Anda bertahan selama-lamanya. Amin.
CLC, make sure you have roots. Make sure your roots go deep. Don't be a tauge Christian.
CLC, pastikanlah akarmu masuk ke dalam dan bertahan kuat. Jangan menjadi orang Kristen tauge.
Allow for the Holy Spirit to give you deep roots.
Izinkan Roh Kudus untuk menumbuhkan akar-akarmu dengan kuat.
Listen now, afterwards when tribulation or persecution arises for the word's sake,
dengar.
Immediately they stumble.
Dengar ayat firman ini. Kemudian ketika datang penindasan atau penganiayaan karena firman itu, segera mereka murtad.
Look at that phrase. Roland just said that phrase. For the word's sake.
Dengarkan kata-kata itu, untuk atau karena firman tersebut.
Notice again that the purpose of tribulation and persecution is to squeeze the word out of you.
Dengarkan, tujuan dari penindasan atau penganiayaan itu adalah mencabut keluar firman itu dari Anda.
Notice again the enemy's strategy is to get the word of God out of you.
Perhatikan, sekali lagi, strategi musuh adalah supaya firman itu keluar dari diri Anda.
Come on, CLC, our eyes must be open. This is what the devil wants to steal.
Ayo, CLC, mata kita harus terbuka. Inilah tujuan daripada si iblis itu.
You have to know, this is what the devil wants to steal from you. It's the word.
Inilah yang ingin dicuri oleh si iblis itu. Ia ingin mencuri firman itu dari Anda.
See, even the CLC dog says amen. Some of you are too quiet. Don't let the CLC dog be the only one that says amen. Come on.
That's right, Pastor. Nah, lihat itu anjing CLC aja berkata amin. Karena Anda semua tidak mengatakan amin. Jadi anjing yang mengatakan amin.
When you listen to the Sunday services, if Roland is interpreting, many times you will hear the CLC dog at the back saying amen. Many times.
That's true, Pastor. Amin, Pastor. Jadi setiap kali Anda mendengarkan saya yang menerjemahkan Pastor, pasti ada anjing CLC yang mengatakan amin.
So the CLC dog is part of CLC Serpong over there, yeah?
Yes, sir. That is right. Jadi anjing sialsi ini adalah bagian dari sialsi serpong nih.
But no, notice it's just, it's for the word's sake.
Jadi perhatikan adalah untuk firman itu, yang mau diambil.
Eyes must be open. The devil wants to steal the word.
Mata kita harus terbuka, si iblis mau mencuri firman itu.
Don't let tribulation, don't let persecution, don't let offense, don't let laziness, don't let lukewarmness rob you of God's word.
Jangan izinkan penindasan atau penganiayaan atau kemalasan atau ketersinggungan itu mencuri firman itu dari Anda. Jangan izinkan hal itu.
And then it says that immediately they stumble, pop, they fell.
Dan kemudian dikatakan oleh firman, seketika mereka murtad, mereka jatuh.
Oh, this is my heart for CLC, that none of you stumble in Jesus name.
Hati saya untuk CLC adalah tidak ada seorang pun dari Anda yang jatuh dalam nama Yesus.
Strong and we not stumble.
Jadilah kuat dan jangan sampai jatuh.
Verse 18, come on, verse 18.
Mari lihat ayat 18.
Now these are the ones sown among thorns.
Dan ini adalah yang ditaburkan di tengah semak duri.
These are the ones who hear the word.
Mereka mendengar firman itu.
And the cares of this world.
Lalu kekhawatiran dunia ini.
Hey, can I tell you something?
Boleh saya beritahu sesuatu?
The cares of this world.
Kekhawatiran dunia ini.
Are real things.
Adalah pencuri benar, yang betul, yang benar.
Listen carefully.
Dengar baik.
The world are real. We are not saying that they're not real.
Kekhawatiran dunia ini kan memang nyata, memang benar. Saya tidak katakan itu tidak nyata.
If you have bills to pay, those are real.
Kalau Anda punya tagihan yang harus dibayar, ya itu nyata.
If you need healing in your body, that is real.
Kalau Anda butuh kesembuhan pada tubuh Anda, itu juga nyata.
If you are believing God to help you with your kids, that is real.
Kalau Anda mempercayai Tuhan untuk menolong anak-anak Anda, itu juga nyata.
If you have challenges at work, that is real.
Kalau Anda punya tantangan dalam pekerjaan, itu juga nyata.
But just because the cares of the world are real,
tapi karena walaupun kekhawatiran-kekhawatiran seperti itu memang nyata,
does not mean that if you will forsake God and look after those cares can turn around, because they will not.
Tidaklah berarti kalau Anda melupakan Tuhan lalu mengurusi kekhawatiran-kekhawatiran itu maka itu akan selesai. Tidak akan begitu.
The way for those cares to be handled, taken care of, cara, is to let God be God to you.
Cara untuk mengurusi atau menyelesaikan kekhawatiran itu adalah mengizinkan Tuhan untuk menolong Anda.
Listen to this now, the cares of the world, the deceitfulness of riches.
Dengarkan, kekhawatiran dunia ini dan tipu daya kekayaan.
Now notice how it says the deceitfulness of riches.
Perhatikan bagaimana dikatakan tipu daya kekayaan.
Oh, you see, pastor, it says there that riches are deceitful, so we shouldn't have any riches.
Oh, pastor, itu dikatakan bahwa kekayaan itu menipu, jadi kita tidak boleh menjadi orang kaya.
No, listen, just because the word says it's deceitful doesn't mean it has to deceive you.
Tidak, tapi hanya karena firman mengatakan bahwa itu bisa menipu Anda, tidak berarti Anda boleh ditipu.
No, what it means here when it says deceitfulness of riches is that you have to understand that riches are not the answer to everything.
Ketika dikatakan tipu daya kekayaan, Anda harus mengerti bahwa kekayaan bukanlah jawaban untuk segala sesuatu.
That is the deceitfulness of riches. When people believe that if I have money, everything will be okay. That is false.
Itulah tipu daya kekayaan, yaitu kalau orang berpikir kalau saya punya uang maka segala sesuatu akan beres, itu yang salah.
Everything is okay when you let God's word take root in your life and you come up strong. That's when everything is okay.
Amin. Segala sesuatu itu baru menjadi baik ketika Anda mengizinkan firman Tuhan itu tumbuh dan berakar kuat di dalam diri Anda. Baru itu menjadi okay.
Nothing wrong with the deceitfulness. Just don't let it deceive you.
Tidak ada yang salah dengan kekayaan itu. Hanya jangan izinkan dia menipu Anda.
Listen, and the desires of other things enter to choke the word.
Dan kemudian dikatakan keinginan akan hal lain menghimpit firman itu.
Notice again.
Perhatikan lagi.
The role of the deceitfulness, the role of the cares is to choke the word.
Peranan dari penipuan dan keinginan hal yang lain itu adalah untuk menghimpit, mematikan firman itu.
TLC, I cannot overemphasize. Look at what God says. We'll look at what is so important about the word of God.
TLC, saya tidak bisa lebih menekankan lagi. Lihat bagaimana pentingnya firman Tuhan ini berkata-kata.
And CLC, we have a standard of the word in CLC.
Dan kita memiliki standar di dalam CLC.
We must not let, in the name of Jesus, we must not let the enemy steal the word from us.
Amin. Dalam nama Yesus, kita tidak boleh izinkan musuh mencuri firman itu dari kita.
Verse 20.
Ayat 20.
But these are the ones sown on good ground.
Tapi ini adalah yang ditaburkan di tanah yang baik.
CLC, I'm declaring over us that we are good ground.
CLC, saya deklarasikan bahwa kita adalah tanah yang baik. Amin.
In the name of Jesus, each and every one of you, I declare that you are good ground. I say that you are good ground to sow the word into.
Amin. Dalam nama Yesus, saya deklarasikan bahwa setiap Anda adalah tanah yang baik di mana firman Tuhan bisa ditaburkan.
Now listen, God is going to give us a definition of good ground.
Dengarkan, sekarang Tuhan akan memberikan definisi daripada tanah yang baik itu.
But these are the ones who are sown on good ground.
Ini adalah yang ditaburkan di tanah yang baik.
One.
Yang pertama.
Those they hear it.
Orang yang mendengarkan.
This is verse 20. They hear it.
Ini ayat 20. Yang pertama, mendengar.
They accept it.
Yang kedua, mereka menerima, menyambut.
So they hear it. Like you are hearing it now. CLC, you are hearing now.
CLC, mendengar, Anda mendengarkan sekarang.
And then two, they accept it. They believe it in their heart.
Dan yang kedua, itu mereka menyambut atau menerima. Mereka menerima dalam hati mereka.
And then three, they bear fruit.
Dan yang ketiga, mereka berbuah.
This is God's definition of good ground.
Inilah definisi Tuhan atas tanah yang baik itu.
Hear it.
Mendengar.
Accept it.
Menerima.
Bear fruit.
Dan menghasilkan buah.
Hear it.
Mendengar.
Accept it.
Menerima.
Bear fruit.
Menghasilkan buah.
TLC, we hear it, we accept it. I tell you now in the name of Jesus, it's time for us to bear fruit.
Amin. CLC, kita sudah mendengar, kita sudah menyambut, dan saya berkata dalam nama Yesus, sekarang adalah saatnya untuk kita berbuah.
It's fruit bearing time for us.
Ini adalah masa di mana kita menghasilkan buah.
And I tell you this, it is time for you to bear fruit in your body. It is time for you to bear fruit in your business. It is time for you to bear fruit in your mind and your emotions. But most importantly, it is time for CLC to bear fruit of CLCs all over the place.
Amin. Ini adalah saat Anda untuk menghasilkan buah dalam tubuh Anda, dalam pikiran Anda, dalam seluruh aspek hidup Anda. Tapi lebih penting lagi, ini adalah saat CLC untuk menghasilkan buah di segala tempat.
Listen, when we do the pastors meetings and we help all those pastors, that is fruit from CLC. But that should not be the only fruit from CLC. CLC itself should have some fruit.
Ketika kita mengadakan konferensi para hamba Tuhan, itu merupakan salah satu contoh buah yang dihasilkan oleh CLC. Tapi bukan hanya itu saja, CLC juga harus menghasilkan buah-buah yang lain.
And I tell you, we will not rest until we bear fruit for the kingdom and we bear fruit for God.
Amin. Dan saya beritahu bahwa kita tidak akan berhenti sampai kita terus menghasilkan buah untuk kerajaan Tuhan.
That's why I say there must be more than one CLC. There must be more. We cannot be happy with just one Sunday service.
Itu sebabnya tadi saya katakan bahwa kita harus memiliki lebih banyak CLC. Kita tidak boleh hanya punya satu ibadah hari Minggu saja.
We must let God lead us to new ways and new avenues and new places and new people.
Amin. Kita harus izinkan Tuhan untuk membawa kita kepada cara baru, kepada jalur-jalur yang baru, ketemu dengan orang-orang baru.
And I have proven to you with my own life,
dan
not just
telah,
the word, but with my own life.
Tapi saya telah membuktikannya bukan hanya dengan firman Tuhan, tapi juga dengan hidup saya sendiri.
With all the challenges that were in front of me, I stood on God's word and I testify to you, God's word will produce for you.
Amin. Dengan segala tantangan yang saya hadapi, saya memilih untuk berdiri teguh di atas firman Tuhan dan saya bisa bersaksi firman Tuhan bisa berhasil dalam hidup kita.
So this is the kind of fruit we should produce. Look at this. And bear fruit. Some 30, some 60, some 100 fold.
Kita lihat firman tadi ayat 20. Ada yang 30 kali lipat, ada yang 60 kali lipat, ada yang 100 kali lipat.
So I asked the Lord one time. I said, why is it some 30, why some 60, why some 100? I don't understand, Lord.
Jadi suatu ketika saya bertanya pada Tuhan, Tuhan saya tidak mengerti mengapa ada yang 30, mengapa ada yang 60, mengapa ada yang 100.
The Lord showed it to me like this.
Dan Tuhan menunjukkan kepada saya seperti begini.
You must pass 30 to go to 60.
Anda harus melewati 30 untuk mencapai 60.
You must pass 60 to go to 100.
Anda harus lewati dulu yang 60 baru mencapai 100.
If you are 30, praise God, you're on your way to 60. If you are 60, praise God, you're on your way to 100.
Jadi kalau Anda pada posisi 30, Anda mesti bersyukur karena Anda sedang menuju 60. Kalau Anda di posisi 60, Anda harus bersyukur karena Anda sedang menuju ke 100.
I told the Lord, I said, God, I don't know where I am. I don't know if I am at 5, 10, 15, 20, 30. I don't know where I am. But wherever I go is 100.
Saya berkata pada Tuhan, Tuhan saya tidak tahu saya ada di mana, apakah di angka 5, 10, 15 atau yang mana. Tapi saya bersyukur bahwa saya sedang menuju angka 100.
CLC, our goal, listen now, our goal is 100-fold production, fruitfulness for the things of God.
Amin. CLC, tujuan kita sekarang adalah mencapai 100 kali lipat produktivitas untuk Tuhan.
I know it's possible because he just promised it to us here in Mark chapter 4. He said we can go to 100-fold.
Amin. Kita tahu itu adalah mungkin karena Tuhan yang berjanji bahwa kita bisa menghasilkan 100 kali lipat.
And I'm telling you, God wants growth. God wants growth for CLC in Setabudi. God wants growth for CLC in Serpong. God wants growth for CLC in Medan. God wants growth for CLC wherever we are. God wants growth for us.
Amin. Dan saya beritahu Anda bahwa Tuhan menginginkan pertumbuhan, pelipat gandaan, baik di Jakarta, baik di Serpong, di Medan, dimanapun Tuhan menginginkan pelipat gandaan.
Let God renew your mind. Let God challenge your spirit, CLC.
Biarlah Tuhan memperbaharui pikiran Anda dan menantang roh Anda, CLC.
Stop thinking of what cannot be and start letting God show you what can be.
Berhentilah berpikir apa yang tidak bisa dilakukan dan mulailah berpikir apa yang bisa dilakukan oleh Tuhan.
Stop thinking about this is how we always do it and let God show you new ways to do things.
Amin. Berhentilah berpikir ini yang biasa kita lakukan, tapi izinkanlah Tuhan memperlihatkan cara-cara baru untuk melakukan sesuatu.
You cannot have a move of God, you cannot have revival unless God does new things.
Anda tidak bisa memiliki kegerakan dari Tuhan, mengalami pergerakan yang baru dari Tuhan, kecuali Anda bisa menerima hal-hal yang baru.
I think that the day of doing things just the way we always do things is over.
Saya kira sekarang saatnya untuk sudah tiba bahwa kita berhenti memikirkan cara-cara yang biasa kita lakukan.
You know, CLC, listen to my heart.
CLC, dengarkan hati saya.
You know, those of you who were here in the early days, you will remember me saying.
Anda yang sudah ada pada masa-masa awal CLC, pasti Anda ingat saya sudah berkata.
With or without people.
Dengan atau tanpa orang-orang.
Whether they support me or not, we can go on and do the, and have the will of God and have the manifestations of God in our life.
Apakah mereka mendukung saya atau tidak, kita tetap akan maju terus dan tetap akan melihat manifestasi dari firman Tuhan.
See, now I tell you the same thing.
Dan CLC sekarang saya juga menyatakan hal yang sama.
We do not open ourselves up to new ways that God can grow us.
Kalau kita tidak mau membuka diri kepada cara-cara baru Tuhan bisa menumbuhkan kita,
then God and me and those who are willing will find new ways and God will open new doors for us.
Maka Tuhan dengan saya dan mereka yang juga mau akan menemukan cara-cara baru dan Tuhan akan membukakan pintu-pintu baru untuk kita.
We must make room for God to open new doors for us.
Amin. Kita harus menciptakan ruangan baru untuk kegerakan Tuhan membuka pintu yang baru buat kita.
And we must not be afraid. We cannot wait for perfection before we walk into those doors.
Dan kita tidak boleh takut dan kita tidak bisa menunggu sampai keadaan semuanya sempurna baru mau membuka pintu itu.
I am believing.
Saya percaya.
For new people to come into CLC.
Ada orang-orang baru yang datang ke CLC.
They may not always do things the same way as everyone else.
Mereka mungkin tidak melakukan dengan cara-cara yang biasa dilakukan oleh yang lain.
May not always even be as perfect as everyone else.
Mungkin juga mereka tidak sempurna seperti orang yang lain.
But that's what happens when you grow.
Tapi itulah yang terjadi ketika Anda bertumbuh.
I'm telling you now. I'm giving you notice.
Saya beritahu Anda sekarang, saya sudah memberikan pemberitahuan.
We cannot keep doing things the same way.
Kita tidak bisa melakukan segala hal dengan cara yang sama.
Are going to be new things.
Akan ada hal-hal yang baru.
There are going to be new people.
Akan ada orang-orang yang baru.
And we must be moved by the word and the spirit of God to allow for this to happen in our midst.
Dan kita haruslah digerakkan oleh firman dan roh Tuhan untuk hal-hal yang baru ini.
CLC, my prayer for us.
CLC, doa saya untuk kita.
That God will enlarge our hearts.
Supaya Tuhan akan melebarkan hati kita.
Some of you in here, I see a few of the names in here. You've been here for a long time.
Saya lihat beberapa nama di sini. Anda sudah bersama dengan CLC sudah begitu lama.
And I love you all and I appreciate you all.
Saya mengasihi Anda semua dan saya menghargai Anda semua.
I'm asking you now.
Dan saya meminta Anda sekarang.
Let God enlarge you.
Izinkanlah Tuhan memperluas Anda.
So that you can help us make room for new people.
Supaya Anda bisa menolong kita untuk menciptakan ruangan baru untuk orang-orang baru.
Some of you in here are newer. Not new, but newer to us.
Beberapa dari Anda sudah lebih baru dari orang-orang yang lebih lama.
And I challenge you.
Dan saya menantang Anda semua.
So your roots go in deep.
Pastikan akar Anda masuk sampai jauh ke dalam.
Go past the tauge phase of Christianity.
Anda harus melewati fase menjadi tauge itu sebagai di dalam kekristenan.
Go deep.
Berakarlah dengan dalam.
God has a plan for you here in CLC.
Tuhan punya rencana untuk Anda di CLC.
For us as a CLC family.
Untuk kita sebagai keluarga CLC.
Come together.
Mari kita bersatu.
That we can be a blessing to Indonesia.
Supaya bisa menjadi berkat untuk Indonesia. Amin.
And allow for God to flow in us and through us.
Mari izinkan Tuhan untuk mengalir melalui kita dan melewati kita.
Come on, wherever you are, let's just lift our hands and let's just commit our hearts to God. I sense the Spirit of God calling for commitment this evening.
Mari dimanapun kita berada, kita angkat tangan kepada Tuhan dan izinkan Tuhan, saya merasakan Tuhan ingin menginginkan komitmen kita.
Come on, right where you are, commit yourself, give yourself to God because God has a plan for your life.
Mari dimanapun Anda berada, komitkanlah diri Anda kepada Tuhan karena Tuhan punya rencana untuk hidup Anda.
I'm not there to lay hands on you. I don't have to be there to lay hands on you because you can commit and say, God, use me. God, move through me. God, send me.
Saya tidak perlu berada di sana untuk menumpangkan tangan kepada Anda sebab Anda sendiri bisa berkata kepada Tuhan, Tuhan, pakailah saya, gunakan saya.
And right where you are, you can talk to God and God can hear you himself.
Dan
you yourself and God himself.
Di mana Anda berada, Anda bisa berkata kepada Tuhan sendiri dan Tuhan bisa berkata kepada Anda sendiri.
Zanganamon delebefrede sukuria siliondolomofrebe zengelebefrede sukolabafrede karabasiliandolomofrebe shkiriande zananafrede gendelebefrede sukorabofrekiste grengaso sonna nambre pele sukuria shkiria sukorabofrede. Come on, stir up the gifts and callings of God that are inside of you. Pray in the Spirit of God. Stir yourselves.
Mari bangkitkanlah roh Tuhan dalam diri Anda. Kobarkan roh Tuhan dalam diri Anda.
Karamande, ezobato robofredo. Come on, the gifts of God on the inside of you. You can stir it. You can stir it. You can stir it.
Mari karunia Tuhan dalam diri Anda bisa dikobarkan. Kobarkanlah.
Gana manfremesa. The gifts and callings of God. The anointings are already on the inside of you.
Panggilan dan urapan Tuhan itu sudah ada dalam diri Anda.
Pray loud enough for you to hear your own self praying. This is the challenge. Pray loud enough for you to hear yourself praying.
Berdoalah cukup keras sampai Anda bisa mendengar diri Anda sendiri berdoa.
I know we're not in like a usual service setting. If we were in a usual service setting, we would have the keyboard playing and we would have different things. But here, learn to train yourself where you can pray in the Spirit of God.
Saya tahu kita tidak seperti di ibadah biasa di mana ada keyboard yang sedang bermain, tapi latihlah diri Anda sendiri untuk berdoa kepada Tuhan.
Father, in the name of Jesus.
Bapa, dalam nama Tuhan Yesus.
Father, I speak and I call for an apostolic and a prophetic flow of the Spirit of God into CLC.
Bapa, aku minta dan aku mendoakan supaya ada aliran apostolik dan profetis di dalam CLC.
Father, that we would be apostolically sent into the nations.
Bapa, supaya kami dikirim secara apostolik ke bangsa-bangsa.
And that we would be prophetically speaking the plans and the purposes of God into the nations.
Dan supaya kami bisa berbicara secara profetis kepada para bangsa-bangsa di dunia ini.
You will raise up sons and daughters in this house.
Engkau akan bangkitkan anak laki dan anak perempuan dalam rumah ini.
And you will raise sons and daughters from this house.
Dan engkau akan mengirim anak-anak laki dan anak-anak perempuan itu dari rumah ini.
And I hear the Spirit of God saying, and this is for us generally. I hear the Spirit of God saying.
Dan aku mendengar Roh Tuhan berkata, ini untuk kita semua. Aku dengar Roh Tuhan berkata,
I'm offering you boldness.
Aku menghadirkan kepadamu keberanian.
Offering you boldness to step into the things that the Spirit of God has already been speaking to you about.
Aku menawarkan kepadamu keberanian untuk masuk kepada apa yang selama ini Roh Tuhan telah menghadirkannya untuk Anda.
So I hear the Spirit of God saying, the things that I place in your heart, the purposes I place in your heart, the visions I place in your heart.
Aku mendengar Roh Tuhan berkata, visi yang telah ditempatkan dalam dirimu, semua keinginan yang telah ditempatkan dalam dirimu.
It takes divine boldness to take and step up and receive that all the Father has for you. So in Jesus' name, CLC, receive a divine infusion of boldness now in Jesus' name.
Diperlukan keberanian ilahi untuk bisa mengambil karunia-karunia itu. Jadi CLC, terimalah keberanian itu dalam nama Yesus.
I declare over you a boldness to hear.
Aku deklarasikan atasmu keberanian untuk mendengar.
A boldness to say.
Keberanian untuk berkata-kata.
A boldness to go.
Dan keberanian untuk pergi.
A boldness to do in Jesus' name.
Keberanian untuk melakukan dalam nama Tuhan Yesus.
Listen, and this is a prophetic message to you.
Dengar, ini adalah sebuah pesan profetis untuk Anda.
Be bold and receive from the Father's boldness.
Jadilah berani dan terimalah keberanian dari Bapa itu.
Because there are some things that will never come to you unless you allow for the boldness of God to bring you into those places now in Jesus' name.
Karena ada beberapa hal yang tidak bisa datang kepada Anda kecuali Anda menerima keberanian itu dalam nama Tuhan Yesus.
The boldness of God, CLC.
Keberanian dari Tuhan, CLC.
What we need and what God has available for us.
Itulah yang kita perlukan dan itulah yang Tuhan sediakan untuk kita.
I could call you all out, but it's not necessary because you have to be bold. To be bold.
Saya bisa saja memanggil nama Anda satu persatu, tapi itu tidak perlu karena Anda bisa jadi berani. Jadilah berani.
It makes you strong when you're bold in the things of God.
Itu membuat Anda kuat waktu Anda menjadi berani.
And I'm challenging you.
Saya menantang Anda.
Walk into the boldness of everything the Father has for you.
Berjalanlah dalam keberanian yang Tuhan telah sediakan untuk Anda.
This week,
minggu ini,
I challenge you.
Saya menantang Anda.
Do something, say something with anything that is not your usual self that God prompts you to do, puts on your heart to do.
Lakukan sesuatu, berkatalah sesuatu yang tidak biasa engkau lakukan yang Tuhan taruh dalam hati Anda.
And you'll see how God can bless you and help you.
Anda akan lihat bagaimana Tuhan memberkati Anda dan melindungi Anda.
You say, oh, I thought on the Wednesday you're going to lay hands on everybody and give everyone a prophecy. Listen, I did. I gave you a prophecy from heaven. Be bold and take everything the Father has.
Anda berkata, oh, saya pikir Anda akan menumpangkan tangan pada setiap kami di ibadah hari Rabu. Saya sudah melakukannya. Dengar, jadilah berani dengan apa yang Tuhan sudah taruh.
You will let the boldness of God overpower you.
Kalau Anda mau izinkan keberanian dari Tuhan itu menguasai Anda.
No devil can stand against you.
Tidak ada iblis bisa bertahan terhadap Anda. Amin.
And I say this from my heart. I really sense the Spirit of God prompting us with this.
Dan saya merasakan, sangat merasakan Roh Tuhan ini mendorong kita untuk hal ini.
Boldness in Jesus' name.
Keberanian dalam nama Yesus. Amin.
Father, so let this be a bold house.
Bapa, biarlah kami menjadi rumah yang berani, Bapa.
May the sons and daughters of this house be as bold as lions, Father.
Biarlah anak laki-laki dan perempuan dari rumah ini menjadi berani seperti singa, Bapa.
May they roar loudly like lions.
Biarlah mereka mengaum dengan kuat seperti singa, Bapa.
May there be a roar from CLC that is heard around the nation.
Biarlah ada auman dari CLC yang terdengar di seluruh bangsa-bangsa.
May many sons and daughters
hear the roar
from CLC, Father, in Jesus' name.
Ya Bapa, biarlah banyak anak-anakmu yang mendengarkan auman dari CLC ini dalam nama Yesus.
Now listen, here are some instructions I hear from the Spirit of God for you.
Dengar, ini adalah beberapa instruksi yang saya dengar dari Roh Tuhan untuk Anda.
Whatever mountains, whatever Goliaths are in front of you.
Apapun gunung, apapun Goliat yang ada di depan Anda.
This week,
minggu ini,
let the lion of the tribe of Judah on the inside of you roar against it.
Amin. Biarlah singa dari Yehuda itu yang ada di dalam diri Anda itu mengaum melawan hal itu.
If you don't know anything else today, just say hallelujah. I take authority over this in Jesus' name.
Kalau Anda tidak tahu mesti berkata apa, katakan saja haleluya, aku mengambil otoritas dalam nama Tuhan Yesus.
If you don't know how to pray, don't know what to say, just say God, you are my Father. That's good enough.
Kalau Anda tidak tahu mesti berdoa apa, katakanlah Tuhan, Engkau adalah Bapa-Ku. Itu saja sudah cukup.
If you don't know how to say Pastor, this thing is so big, I don't even know how to pray. Just say God, you are my Father. Daddy, save me.
Kalau Anda tidak tahu mesti berkata apa, ini terlalu besar, Pastor. Katakanlah, Ayah, tolong saya. Bapa, tolong saya.
Listen, your Father wants to save you more than you want to save yourself.
Dengar, Bapa Anda itu mau menyelamatkan Anda lebih daripada keinginan Anda untuk menyelamatkan diri Anda.
And I challenge you.
Dan saya menantang Anda.
Roar at your mountain.
Mengaumlah terhadap gunung Anda itu.
Prophesy to your Goliath and tell your Goliath in Jesus' name your head is going to fall off.
Amin. Berkatalah, bernubuatlah kepada Goliath Anda itu, hey Goliath, kepalamu akan putus.
Amin. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father.
Terima kasih, Bapa.
I want to encourage you to be faithful with your tithes and your offerings.
Saya ingin mendorong Anda untuk tetap setia dengan perpuluhan dan persembahan Anda.
Be bold in your giving.
Jadilah berani dengan pemberian Anda.
I want to encourage you to be bold talking to your friends and relatives.
Saya ingin mendorong Anda juga untuk berani bicara dengan sanak saudara dan teman-teman Anda.
Invite them to our next Thank God It's Wednesday.
undanglah mereka dalam acara ibadah hari Rabu berikutnya.
We are working on the safest and the best ways to start having live services again.
Kita sedang berusaha untuk bisa segera beribadah secara tatap muka dengan cara yang aman lagi.
Be bold to invite your friends.
Ketika hal itu sudah terlaksana, jadilah berani untuk mengundang teman-teman Anda.
There's no point talking about God. We want CLC to grow, but we refuse to invite anyone.
Tidak ada gunanya kita bicara tentang kebaikan Tuhan, tentang mau berkembang, tapi kita tidak mau mengundang siapapun.
Oh, listen, CLC's growth, you have a part and a responsibility in that. You understand?
Dengarkan, jemaat CLC, Anda juga punya tanggung jawab dan harus berbuat sesuatu tentang hal itu.
Be bold to believe God and be big.
Jadilah berani untuk percaya Tuhan dan lakukanlah yang besar.
In Jesus' name, amen.
Dalam nama Yesus, amin.
To be bold because we have Christ in us.
Kita harus berani sebab kita memiliki Kristus di dalam diri kita.
Amen. Amen. Be bold.
Jadilah berani.
I would like everybody to please stand up and raise your hand.
Mari saudara semua, kita berdiri dan kita angkat tangan.
I know, you also have sent your offerings and your tithes, so let us pray and give thanks to God.
Saya tahu saudara sudah memberikan perpuluhan dan persembahan, mari kita berdoa.
Okay, let us raise our hands towards that.
Mari kita angkat tangan.
All right, Lord, Heavenly Father, thank you for this opportunity to give.
Bapa, terima kasih untuk kesempatan kami dapat memberi.
Lord, I thank you that your word is always true.
Tuhan, terima kasih firman-Mu selalu nyata.
That as we give, it will be given back unto us.
Ketika kami memberi, akan diberikan kepada kami.
And it's in good measure, shaken together, running over.
Takaran yang baik digoncangkan, tumpah keluar.
That as we give, we are blessed back.
Saat kami memberi, kami diberkati kembali.
We are blessed to become a blessing.
Kami diberkati untuk menjadi berkat.
We are blessed to impact lives of people.
Kami diberkati untuk memberi dampak bagi orang lain.
CLC is a blessed church.
CLC adalah gereja yang diberkati. Amin.
Thank you, Father.
Terima kasih, Bapa.
The Lord bless you and keep you.
Tuhan memberkati engkau.
The Lord makes his face shine upon you and be gracious to you.
Tuhan menyinari engkau dengan wajah-Nya dan memberi engkau kasih karunia.
The Lord showers you with his favor.
Tuhan mencurahi engkau dengan perkenanannya.
Nothing lost, nothing broken in the name of Jesus.
Tidak ada yang hancur, tidak ada yang aku perkatakan damai atasmu.
Blessings I speak over you.
Aku perkatakan berkat atasmu.
Father, we give you all the things in the mighty name of Jesus, and everybody say,
Bapa,
amen,
kami persembahkan
amen,
segalanya
amen.
Kepadamu. Semua katakan, amin, amin, amin.
All right, thank you everybody for what for being here with us.
Terima kasih saudara sudah bersama kami.
And have a blessed Sunday.
Selamat menikmati hari Minggu yang diberkati.